Wembley tradition, Frank Rea mounts the rostrum to conduct a 100,000 cup final crowd in community singing. Another cup final custom. The teams walk out together, West Ham nearest in view. Their opponents, Preston North End. This is the biggest day in the English football year, the match for the FA Cup. And today it's London versus Lancashire with West Ham favourites. Except, of course, in Lancashire. Each team includes one youngster, 18-year-old John Sissons for the Hammers, and for Preston, an even younger player, Howard Kendall, only 17, and youngest ever cup finalist. Nobby, Lawton, Preston and West Ham skipper Bobby Moore beat referee Arthur Holland. The official spins the coin and it's a good start for West Ham. Moore wins the toss. For Preston, Alex Dawson kicks off. Luckily for Preston, left back Jim Smith is first to the ball and the Northerners look dangerous. Now see in slow motion how Jim Standen, in the West Ham goal, is equal to the occasion. Again, West Ham have a narrow escape. Ashworth shoots wide. That stings the Londoners into retaliation. Inside left, Geoff Hurst is tackled by Tony Singleton. Kelly save. Again, it's Preston with outside left Doug Holden menacing West Ham. There's no holding Preston, and after 9 minutes, Doug Holden puts the ball in the net. We'll look at it in detail, in slow motion, which is football as it would be if the players had all the time in the world. This is the time for West Ham to pull something out of the bag. A good pass finds John Sissons and it's the equaliser. Back in the game, West Ham try again, but Geoff Hurst's header is well saved. A determined Preston attack earns them a corner. Holden places the kick well. Jim Standen only partially clears. Preston skipper Nobby Lawton just misses. Much the same thing happens at the other end. Brabrook heads and then Johnny Byrne is high, wide, but not handsome for the Hammers. Preston go all out to regain the lead. Standen concedes a corner. Wilson takes the kick. Centre forward, Alec Dawson heads a goal. Preston lead 2-1. Bring on the guard band. It's a safe bet. They've had a pep talk during the interval. Anyway, they lose no time showing the fighting spirit that got them into the final. Outside right, Peter Braybrook is challenged by Jim Smith. Not quite successfully, a corner for West Ham. Braybrook's kick is just what the Hammers ordered. Centre-half Ken Brown is there, not quite on target. Geoff Hurst does better. And yes, sir, Alan Kelly just fails to keep the ball out. That all happened so quickly. Let's see just how West Ham scored the equaliser. Obviously time for West Ham to go into a huddle. Another corner for West Ham. And another escape for Preston. Spurred on by that reverse, Preston become as dangerous as they were in the first half. It's fortunate for the Londoners that Jim Standen's in great form. This looks like developing into a goal-mouth scramble, which West Ham will do well to survive. Preston centre-forward Alex Dawson finds Standen unbeatable. Geoff Hurst makes ground, then passes to Brabrook. A promising move. We'll follow it in slow motion. Sissons takes a corner, and in trying to clear, goalkeeper Alan Kelly is injured. Everybody asks, is this the dreaded Wembley hoodoo? Fortunately, Kelly was able to carry on. And almost in the last seconds of the game, West Ham inside right Ronnie Boyce heads into the net. And this is just how it happened. West Ham's third goal, which won them the cup. Johnny Byrne starts a one-man training session. Bobby Moore, captain of West Ham, captain of England, and at this moment happy as any man alive, leads his men to receive the trophy and winner's medal. Lord Harewood represents the Queen. A lap of honour now by the 11 excited men who have won the most highly prized sporting trophy in the world. The general verdict, the best final for many a year. Serve them right as their best girls walk out on them. In the winner's dressing room, you'd expect to see champagne. You have a surprise in store. The drink on the house is milked. If that's their choice, nobody can say they don't thrive on it. This must be the first time the FA Cup has been so misused. Some for the club cat.